Callie, and today I'd like to give you a few basic tips on phrasing, so you can phrase beautifully and musically every time you play. While taking musical risks in performance is absolutely essential to the beauty of performing live, don't rely on feeling the music in the heat of the moment, because what if you're feeling unbearably sad? But the music is supposed to be upbeat and crazy and obnoxious. Well, you're gonna have to come up with a plan to make it sound that way, even though you're just not feeling it at that moment. Here's a super basic phrasing tip. When the notes get higher, get louder. When the notes get lower, get softer. I learned that when in fourth grade, and suddenly everybody thought I was super talented. I just did what my teacher told me to, and it sounded really musical. So if you do that, chances are it'll sound pretty musical too. The next step in phrasing is to really pay attention to the harmonic structure of the piece. If the notes are getting higher in pitch, but it sounds like the piece or the phrase is resolving, you probably won't want to get louder, you'll probably want to get softer. So if you're very sensitive to the harmonic progression of the piece, and you plan your phrasing according to that, chances are it'll sound even more musical than step one. So a slightly more advanced tip is to bring out more interesting sounding notes and to come away from less interesting sounding notes. For example, we want to play into more dissonant lines and play a little bit less as the line resolves. So just use your ear to help guide you in what sounds the most musical. Next, make sure you use really smooth air. Your air is in charge of the phrasing. Clarinet players have this weird habit of swelling on individual notes, and we think we're being really musical when in fact we're not being musical at all. It just sounds like we have a breathing problem. So other instruments may not have this problem as much. Clarinet players definitely do. So make sure you're using very smooth air. Of course, you could change your air based on the character of the piece, whether there are accents, things like that. But don't swell on individual notes unless you really, really mean to. Next, pick a note in each phrase that the phrase is leading to and going away from. So most of the time, if you start a phrase a little bit softer, grow to the high point of the phrase that you decided on, and then come away from that, it'll sound very musical and beautiful. A good rule of thumb, if you're still having trouble, is what would you do if you were to sing it? We always want to mimic what the human voice would do, and of course that sounds the most musical, so try to mimic what you would do if you were singing it. So these tips are merely just tips. They're not the rules of phrasing. You have to really think about what you're doing and figure out what makes the most sense to you with the music that you're playing, appropriate to the style and the character that the composer is looking for. The whole point of this practice tip is to get everybody thinking about phrasing, to plan out your phrasing, and to just make sure everything you always do is just musical all the time. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, happy practicing!